Listen, if you keep to this message, let me tell you, it could be very hard for the hand of the enemy to touch you. If you keep to this message, it could be very hard for the hand of witches and wizards to touch you. Because those who have clean hands, God protect them. Those who are faithful to Christ, Jesus protect them. No matter battle, no one can succeed them. Open your Bible. Matthew 18, 21 to 35.
The book of Matthew chapter 18, verse 21 to 35.
Yes.
Then Peter came to Jesus and asked.
Peter, come meet Jesus. He called, ask Jesus.
Lord. How many times shall I forgive my brother when he sins against
you
me?
You see, how many times I forgive my brother when he sins against me?
Up to 7 times.
He says to Jesus, 7 times.
Verse 22.
Hallelujah.
Jesus answered. I tell you. Not seven times. But 77 times.
77 times. How many times be that?
77 times.
77 times. Okay, come here. Your brother does sin against you 77 times. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
So those who they run out of their marriage, your husband sin against you 77 times?
No, sir.
Your wife sin against you 77 times?
No, sir.
He says people they trip to hellfire. Are you here, church?
Yes, sir.
So many people here, you see your mother and they run. Your mother sin against you 77 times?
No, sir.
No, what of your copper person? Is he against you 77 times?
No, sir.
Praise the Lord, church.
Hallelujah.
So, sin of all forgiveness is the highest sin. Sin, when you're not going to forgive your brother, your sister, is the highest sin. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So, if you are obeying the voice of God, who says, love one another, it go to very hard for enemy to touch you. Praise the Lord, church.
Hallelujah.
I pray for somebody today.
I receive it.
As you forgive, Jesus will start to fight your battle.
Amen.
As you forgive, Jesus will start to fight your battle.
Amen.
I said Jesus will start to fight your battle.
Amen.
Jesus will start to fight your battle.
Amen.
Let your amen be light.
Amen.
All right, read on.
Verse 23.
Yes.
Therefore, the kingdom of heaven is like a king who wanted to settle account with his servants.
You see, a kingdom of God. It's like a king
who wants to settle account with his servants. Verse 24.
Yes.
As he began the settlement, a man who owed him 10,000 talents.
Listen, a man who owed him 10,000 talents
was brought to him.
It was brought to the king.
Verse 25.
Hallelujah.
Since he was not able to pay, the master ordered that he and his wife and his children and all that he had be sold to repay the debt.
You see, so long as I don't have the money to pay, the king said that sells that man with the wife and his children to pay the debt.
Verse 26.
Hallelujah.
The servant fell on his knees before him.
You see, the servant fell on his knees before the king.
Be patient with me.
He said, be patient with me.
He begged. And I will pay back everything.
Listen, and this man will say, if you forgive me, I will pay back everything when I owe you. Don't sell me and my children and my family.
Verse 27.
Yes.
The servant's master took pity on him. Cancel the debt and let him go.
He said, cancel the debt and let him go.
Verse 28.
Yes.
But when that servant went out, he found one of his fellow servants who owed him 100 denarii.
The man would have forgiven as he went out. He sees someone who holds himself debt.
He grabbed him and began to choke him.
And he sees the man.
Pay back what you owe me.
And he says, you must pay me my money.
He demanded.
And he demanded.
Verse 29.
Hallelujah.
His fellow servant fell to his knees and begged him.
Listen, the fellow servant fell on his knees and begged the man, will they just forgive now?
Be patient with me.
And he said, be patient with me.
And I will pay you back.
And I will pay you back.
Verse 30.
Amen.
But he refused.
Instead.
He went up and had the man thrown into prison until he could pay the
debt. And he went up, arrested the man, and put him into prison. Mona, listen, church. You owe debt like 2 million. And the man said, he will sell you, your wife and your children, to pay the debt, and you beg. And the man said to you, I forgive you the 2 million. Don't pay, go freely. As you are going, you see somebody when you hold your debt, and you seize the person, and the person go on your knee to beg you, and you not forgive. And you throw the person into prison. Carry on.
Verse 31. When the other servants saw what had happened, they were greatly distressed.
They were greatly distressed.
And went and told their master everything that had happened.
And they go, they told their master, Master, the man when you forgive just now, you see someone when you hold him dead and he put him in the prison.
Verse 32.
Yes.
Then the master called the servant in. You wicked servant. He said. I canceled all that debt of yours because you begged me to.
He said, I canceled all the debt because you begged me, and I forgive you.
Verse 33.
Yes.
Shouldn't you have had mercy on your fellow servant just as I had on you?
Hallelujah.
Verse 34.
Amen.
In anger. His master turned him over to the jailers.
And he hold him again. You will not go free because I forgive you. You don't want to forgive.
To be told.
Praise the Lord. Wait. This man, he don't forgive his fellow servant. And he threw him to prison. Where they want to throw himself put now?
The same prison.
So, if you don't forgive, your enemy is inside prison. You are said, you are inside prison. You understand?
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You see someone, you put him in the prison. You yourself, you will enter prison. It's spiritually. Are you in this place?
Yes, sir.
Finish it.
Verse 34.
Yes.
In anger, his master turned him over to the jailers.
Yes.
To be tortured until he should pay back all he owed.
He said, he don't forgive him again.
At all.
He said, he must pay back because I forgive you. You not forgive others. So the money when I say go freely, bring it back to me.
Verse 35, the last verse.
Hallelujah.
This is how my heavenly Father will treat each of you.
Those.
Unless you forgive your brother from your heart.
You see, unless you do what?
You forgive your brother from your heart.
Unless you do what?
You forgive your brother from your heart.
Unless you do what?
You forgive your brother from your heart.
Praise the Lord, church.
Hallelujah.
So, anyone who sin against you, if you not forgive, the same challenge you will face. You understand?
Yes, sir.
For many people is here, you have enemy. You don't want to forgive. I, God, could hear your prayer. You are once a sinner before Jesus arrived to have a covenant with his Father. To say that I'm going there to die for them, even though they are sinners. And he died for you to forgive you all your sin. That's why you are still alive. Because you are saved now by the mercy. You are saved by the blood of Jesus. When he sacrificed in the cross of Calvary for your sins. For you not to waste away. So you don't have any excuse where you're not going to forgive your brother. No excuse. Tell your neighbor. Say no excuse.
No excuse.
Say it.
No excuse.
Say it.
No excuse.
Say it.
No excuse.
All right. Proverbs 28, 13 to 14. Hurry up.
The book of Proverbs chapter 28, verse 13 to 14.
Yes.
He who conceals his sins does not prosper.
Those who hide his sins does not prosper.
But whoever confesses and renounces them
finds mercy. You see, whoever confesses sins and renounces them
find mercy.
Find what?
Mercy.
Find what?
Mercy.
Find what?
Mercy.
So mercy is not for everybody. Mercy is for those who confess their sins and show mercy to others. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
You understand the message?
Yes, sir.
Repeat that verse of Bible.
The book of Proverbs chapter 28, verse 13 to 14.
Yes.
He who conceals his sins.
Anyone who hiding his sins
does not prosper.
He said you will not prosper.
But whoever confesses and renounces them finds mercy.
He said whoever confesses them and renounces them finds mercy.
Verse 14, the last verse.
Hallelujah.
Blessed is the man who always fears the Lord.
He says, blessed is the man who always fears God.
But he who hardens his heart,
anyone who hardens his heart,
falls into trouble.
Fall into temptation. On that day, your church.
Yes, sir.
So, you, many people is here. You see, secret sin against someone. And you forget to renounce it. You cannot flee. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
You cannot flee. Jesus cannot show you mercy. Unless you renounce your sin to those who you sin against. To forgive you. Mostly issue of marriage. Listen to me, church. If a man go to outside and sleep with another woman, well, not a wife. If he not confess for a wife, no prosperity, rising and falling, challenge, bitterness, nightmare. Even though you call me pastor, I confess for pastor, even though the pastor pray prayer of mercy, you will not be forgiven. Unless you confess it to your wife. When your wife forgive you, before Christ, we forgive you. Before any pastor, we pray for you to have mercy. Also, woman too. If you go to outside and commit adultery against your husband, and you don't renounce it, you don't call and say, ah, my husband, I sinned against you. In secret place, Satan tempt me, and you keep it to yourself. No heaven for you. Tell your neighbor, say neighbor.
Neighbor.
It's not the way you look Christianity.
It's not the way you look
Christianity. Is very deeper.
Christianity is very deeper.
Say it again.
Neighbor, it's not the way you look Christianity. Christianity is very deeper.
Praise the Lord, church.
Hallelujah.
And many of you here, you harden your heart. You harden your heart. For you to harden your heart, your prayer is stomach. Because you refuse to confess your sins.
Mercy say no. I'm gonna let you go. I'm gonna let you sleep away. You don't have to be afraid. Mercy said no. Never take control.
Thank you, Jesus. Mercy said.
Hallelujah.
No more we escape in the last day. No more we defend himself in the last day. No more we say, Master, I didn't hear the message. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you in this place?
Yes, sir.
Because the things of God, it go with direction, with true preaching. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
So whoever hear the true preaching, and you not obey, no excuse, the last day. No remedy, the last day. Because no matter you live, even though Christ not arrive, your last day will come. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
No matter you live, even though we pray the whole family cause today, we destroy them. God show you mercy. He can scatter them. You cannot live forever. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because here is not our home. Even though you set free, even though I pray for you, you can't pray to, you never reach home. Are you in this place?
Yes, sir.
Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Brother, I give you the whole water. Speak right. And such and what that take place. You can't live forever. We are joined to in them. And nobody knows why we are preparing this program. I want to tell you the deep secret. Jesus goes to arrive. And no demon possessed we enter the kingdom. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
That's why Jesus tell me to arrange this program. To destroy the family curse. For his children to serve him. The spirit. And the truth. But your own motive, you want to go and destroy the family cause for you to have breakthrough. Yes, breakthrough will come, but you will die labor. Wealth, riches will arrive, children will come. But if the righteous not take place in time, your end will come. Who know that here? Many have close to their end. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
But they don't know. The program stands for a purpose. This church, we know the whole program, the way church is whole program because of money. Dedicate program every day all over the whole world. Pastors, different type of program. Yes, they are using you for ritual to make money, not to prepare you for the kingdom of God. But this program, this is the meaning. Anybody who possess, anybody who will not have the spirit of God, no heaven. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
And the idol where your father and your mother serve, they hold you, they tie you, not to make heaven. Any family they serve idol, the idol who is in charge of the children of that family. Praise the Lord. He made them not to serve God, the spirit and the truth. For them not to have the Holy Spirit. Because when you get the Holy Spirit, you are succeed. You are above Lucifer. Are you in this place?
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because Jesus told me that all my children, they love me from their heart. They go to church 24 hours of the day. But they deny my power. They don't know me. You see? How many people is here? After the program, you go see, go back to your boyfriend and your girlfriend. You see, go back to that man where you never pay your daddy. You go see, go back to that woman where I never paid daddy because it's not born for you. You're not supposed to come. That's why today, forgiveness and mercy. I will preach from tomorrow. Are you in this place?
Yes, sir.
If I give you oil, and don't you oil, salt, water, everything from this altar, people not even know the purpose of giving in this church. I'm not giving you because of only prosperity. Your spiritual life is dormant. You are not seeing the kingdom when they are preparing you to go. You are not seeing it. But you see nightmares. Wishes and wings are pursuing you. You eat in your dreams. You make love. So swim forever. Many people seem masculine. So sick me not because. So snake. And a child of God supposed to have revelation. I see the things of heaven. Not the things of pit of hell. So you are seeing the property of hellfire. Why are you not seeing the property of heaven? Are you here?
Yes, sir.
So, if you are a child of God, you see the things of heaven, not the things of hellfire. Because snake, Lucifer, queen of the ghost, husband, spirit, spiritual life, they are property of hellfire. Are you here, church?
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
A church, when God brings to this generation to save you, if you not be so, you are not going to church before. You're going to church is for words. You're going to church is for position, just earthly position. Make them not say you are a Christian, but your heart, you are not a Christian. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Because the heavenly ways, it go with instruction. You must follow the instruction. If you don't follow the instruction, nothing for you. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you here?
Yes, sir.
You did here?
Yes, sir.
So people said they sleep against their husband and they can't confess to their husband. And they are still going to church 24 hours of the day. You are condemned. You are condemned. After we give the water, many people will not use it to pray for their spiritual life. Anything when they disturb me, not to have the Holy Spirit, Jesus cast it out. Anything when they disturb me, not to serve the living God, the Spirit, and the truth. Father, deliver me. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Any change in my ways, in my life, dragging me to hellfire, Jesus cut it off. Because no time. No time. Wash. What is going on? I preached last week. Say, all the signs. When Christ is about to give to a man, to not say he's closed, he have give all. But man never know. But bird, no. Fish, no. The rest animal, they know. The animal will live in heaven. Oh, no. Because as you are preparing to make it, some animal, they are preparing to go. That's why when Noah blow the trumpet, evil men not hear, but animal hear the voice of the trumpet. Are you here?
Yes, sir.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You see? That's why when I preach, people they hate that. First time people go to TV Joshua to collect water, not because of righteousness. They want their business to grow. They want to have children. Nonsense. We prepare gift here for your spiritual life to be built.
You are right, sir.
Because no matter you achieve, if Jesus does not arrive in time, your end will come.
You are right, sir.
Are you here?
Yes, sir.
This church is a threat to churches. It's a threat to the whole church in the whole world. Because I condemn their church to the word of God.
You are right, sir. Very correct.
I condemn their church to the message of Christ. Because they are not following the Bible. They are following their own stomach sake. And they will take on somebody. Booyah. I don't want me to know me. I want me to know Jesus. If I want me to know me, you're not going to sit for front. How much you get? I for don't arrange group of Moses, group of Peter, group of James, group of Apostle Paul, and those who did that group. When you do that group, me, you are paying huge amount of money to the church. So when you come my program, I arrange you. I will use someone to come and carry you. Put you in the front. The poor people will stay at the back. But now, you are poor. You are in the front of the church. No church you go, you see, is like that.
Son of man, take off your life. What shall be the end of your life? When is the poor shall pass it away? Son of man, seek of your life. Son of man, seek of your life. What
church is a threat to all churches because always he pronounces the genuine pastor. They are in plank church, they hide and they grow annoying. Father, I'm going to take commands to tell the whole world. I'm going to take commands to tell the whole world what is going on because no helper. Lucifer cover them. Make people not hear their voice. Those who God call, when they fear to preach, when they are preaching the truth, they hide. No money to come aside. Jesus, bring this channel for the whole world to know that you see, have some children. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Are you in this place?
Yes, sir.
This church is not a church of material.
At all.
I'm not prepared the water for you to go and reach over and forget God. I prepare it for you to understand that Christ is alive. God is God. When man dies, you have somewhere to go. Because my preaching goes this way. A prostitute, the materialities of God, is not the work for them. You know. Those drinking alcohol, spiritual things of God cannot work for them. Those adultery, fornicators, lesbians, 419, it cannot work for them. If he worked for them, me, you are telling me that a house of God with things of idol are the same. And they are not the same. You did it?
Yes, sir.
Are you annoyed?
No, sir.
So, this gift, when you hold it, just don't say you hold property of repentance and holiness. So you must be holy before the thing will answer. Nobody is telling you that way. Come and buy. Come and buy. You don't buy your house, fool, remain. You never buy.